Thank you. That's very kind. You don't have to clap for me. Hi, everybody. My name is Allie Tarwater. I am the band and orchestra teacher here at Montpelier High School and the middle school strings teacher at Mainstream Middle School. I am so excited for this evening. This is my first composition concert, and this has been... Okay, I'm not going to cry. High schoolers. Okay. this has really, truly been one of the most rewarding experiences of my teaching career. I have not taught kids how to compose before, and learning about how students process music at different age levels, like I get to see them 5th through 12th grade. It's so interesting and so amazing to watch them create in a setting that we all love to do. And it's just so, especially for the youngest ones who are just learning how to read music and being so experimental and like have absolutely no bounds. It's very, very cool. So thank you for giving us this opportunity to share our pieces with you this evening. I'd love to introduce to you my friend Eric Nielsen. Eric. Eric is our resident composer, and he has been working with this program for 10 years? Yeah, I think this is either 9th or 10th year. So huge shout out to Hillary Goldblatt for starting this program too. What an incredible So Eric and Hillary had a wonderful partnership for many years, bringing composition to our students and giving them this opportunity. And we also have, you know, an incredible composition program in Vermont called Music Comp, where Eric's a senior mentor, and we have a lot of students who have participated in that. Jamie's about to premiere a piece with the Vermont Philharmonic. Callum just premiered a piece with the Vermont Symphony that have given them these amazing opportunities that high schoolers don't normally get. This is so unique, such a cool program. So Eric, I'm gonna ask Eric to come up and tell you guys a little bit about the process and how we approached this session.
Thanks, Allie. Every year is a little bit different when we're working, but the process in a lot of ways is the same. I come in to each class 5 times during the period of 2 months or so, and in between the students get to work on a piece. There really aren't any boundaries except for the instrumentation. For the middle schoolers, they're writing for high school students to play, and so that's string players. And then each year with high school, we're working with a different combination of instruments, so we have quite a variety this year, as you'll see. But in terms of the kids' inspiration, it's really interesting to watch, because some kids just start right off and they have an idea and they run with it. And for other kids, it's a slower process. My job is to listen to what they're doing, to talk to them about it, to hear, to try and get inside the piece of music. That's my job, is to try and get inside what it is so that I can understand. And this may sound funny, but it's the way I think of teaching composition. I'm trying to hear where the piece wants to go, where it needs to go. And then I try and convey that to the student. It's not where I want it to go, it's the piece talks to me. And as somebody who's been composing for a long time, I've learned to trust that. And the thing that is wonderful about this is that this is a potentially life-changing experience. Because with the creative arts, these students are learning something they can't get anywhere else. They can point to a piece of music that they wrote and they can say, this came from me. No one else created this. And if they realize that, that's a tremendous amount of empowerment that they can take with them everywhere, no matter whether they write more music in their lives or not. And so it's very humbling for me, because I didn't really start composing until I was 20. So even the 5th graders here are ahead of me. And so it's just wonderful to watch. It's wonderful to be part of. And to all you parents out there, thank you for sharing your children with us. And please encourage them to keep creating.
Thank you so much, Eric. So we'll go ahead and get started. So there is a little bit of transition time for those of you who have not been to a composition concert before. We have different groups of instruments that will come up and play each piece. So the middle school students were able to compose their piece for any combination of violin, viola, bass, and cello, and flute, because that is my main instrument. And so you'll see all these different combinations, duets, trios, quartets, and more tonight. So I'm going to invite our first composer up, Charlotte Goodwin, who is going to introduce her piece.
My piece is called Echoes of the Mountains, and it's a duet with the violin and viol.
And one thing I don't remember if I told everybody, I might have told the high schoolers, but at the end of our piece, or the end of your piece, when the audience claps, will you stand so the audience can clap for you, composer? So everybody stands at the end of your piece. And Reagan, maybe you can give us a little light so we can see those composers. Is that okay?
Can't do that, sorry.
Oh, never mind. Well, just clap for the composer. Give them a wave, composers. All right, take it away, friends. Ensemble and composer up. Our next ensemble is, our next piece is called The Subtle Monkey by Harry Evans. Come on up, Harry.
Hello, everybody. It's an honor to be out here today, and I made the piece called The Subtle Monkey, and I like monkeys, and I wrote this for bass and cello, and
thank you.
we did not almost lose a microphone, Reagan. Okay, so our next piece is by Issa. And Issa, are you here? I haven't seen you yet today. Oh, hi, Issa. Issa, come on up and introduce your piece.
My piece is called Enchanted. It's a composition of violin and flute. hold on. I'm thinking of what I was going to say. Right. I want to thank Mr. Nielsen for helping me and Ms. Tarwater because I just couldn't figure out how to harmonize it, and that was good. So, yeah. I hope you enjoy it.
Issa, what instrument do you play?
Oh, yeah.
She plays violin. Every kid in middle school orchestra composes a piece, and then because there's so many awesome kids, Eric and I have to make the tough decision to choose a couple of pieces that are completed, and we help them finesse those pieces in the end, and they come here this evening. We're going to move on to sixth grade now, so I'm going to ask Satyuk to come up and introduce her piece.
A duet with cello and violin, and it's called Dragonfly.
Thank you.
next composer, Eden Kelly, is not one of my orchestra students. We're very lucky to have, like I said, Eric come help us every day, over the past couple of weeks. Eric's granddaughter is a composer, Eden, and so Eden's piece was chosen as well this year. And I'd like to invite Eden to come up and introduce her piece.
Hi, my name is Eden Kelly. My piece is called Fantasy, and it's written for flute, cello, and bass. Hope you like it.
Is that we get to practice chamber music now, and that's not something we get to do all the time, and so it's giving us a cool opportunity to practice being in a small ensemble together too, and having a more soloistic role. Abe Rosenberg, would you like to come up and introduce your piece?
Hopscotch at dusk. Had to give a little pause there. And it's written for bass, cello, and violin.
Thank you.
We're talking about how that one section is like, oh, spooky. The villain has arrived. I love it. Well done, Eve. Okay, our next composer is Winnie Lou. Winnie, come on up and introduce your piece.
Hi, my name is Winnie Lou. I play violin. My piece is called Intense Socks, and it's for violin and cello.
Chance you're here. Okay. Isla, I will play this with you. Saoirse, is it okay if you have a flute on your piece? Thank you. Our next piece is by Saoirse Sinclair Murphy, and she's going to come introduce her piece real quick.
Spring Day, and it's for violins. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you for your flexibility, Saoirse. Sorry about that. Our next piece is Meek by Mika Jacobson. Mika, come on down.
My piece is called Untitled Title. I came up with that name because I was looking for something to name it. I didn't want to go through all the process of looking at it. What does it sound like? Untitled Title. I didn't want to leave it as untitled. It's for cello and violin. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Okay. Well done, seventh graders. All right, moving on to eighth graders. Thomas, come on down.
My name is Thomas Stimmick. I wrote this piece with the help of Mr. Nielsen and Ms. Tarwater. It is a duet between viola and violin. I play the violin. Hope you guys enjoy.
Charlotte Dumpsey. Come on, Charlotte.
Thank you.
families. Like, we've got siblings playing for other siblings. Oh, so sweet. It's awesome. So Grace is Charlotte's sister, and Asa is Abe's brother, and we have the Robocheck family up playing, too. So cool. All right. Our last piece before our quick intermission is by Atticus Wife. Atticus, come on up.
Violin, and my piece is concerto for three instruments, even though it is a concerto. It's for viola, violin, and cello. Enjoy.
Composers. One more big hand for all our middle school composers. Well done. Thank you, MHSers, for playing for them. So grateful for you. We're going to take about a 7-minute intermission, so go use the bathroom, get some water. Regan, will you turn on those lights for us, if you can? And we'll be back in just a moment with our high school compositions. Thank you. Shout out to Reagan Bridgman. Thank you, Reagan, for being here. We're so grateful for running Sound and Lights for us. Thank you, Orca Media, for being here for live streaming our event so we can watch it later, too. Thank you. And thank you, Callum, for being our sound guy today. Callum's testing out a really, really nice microphone. So we got some nice sound happening and some great lighting and this beautiful space. So lucky. So lucky. Okay, so we're going to go, I just told the high schoolers, be on deck. We're going to move through these, so be ready before your piece. I probably won't say your name before you come up, so just come on up after the musicians have cleared. Does that make sense? But I will introduce our first person, who is Simon Reeves, who is a new student to band this year, and we're so glad you have joined us, Simon. Come on up.
My name is Simon, and my piece is called Stagnation Falls.
Lucia, and my piece is called Hopeful's First Journey. When I wrote it, all my friends told me it sounded like a sea shanty, so I asked ChatGPT what that would look like, and here it is.
Our next piece is written by a freshman trumpet player named Maud Walker, and she says, "Hello, my name is Maud Walker, and I wrote this piece, Birds. It's a trio featuring the French horn, clarinet, and flute. I chose this title because the flute part reminds me of birds in spring. I hope you enjoy it."
Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Yoan, and I wrote a piece for the violin, clarinet, and bass. And my piece is titled... it's a bit of a long one. Schlanver plus windgils go gerth I windrob will plenty silio go go go.
Philip? Okay. I'll move, sorry. Move my arm, just kick my knees out there. I, first of all, just want to say iPads for all. Joanna here is playing off her iPad with a foot pedal, and I'm like, can we just get a bunch from the school for all these musicians? It'd be pretty sick. It's pretty nice. while we are getting ready for this piece, I'm going to do a quick introduction of my wonderful friends here who are playing music. So this is Joanna Alpizar, Michael. And we've got Taylor Goodwin, Julia Bodwin, Aaron Eberhardt, and Jeremy Tarwater over there.
All Whispering Wind.
Dear friend Jackson is in Austria skiing. Oh, poor Jackson. So I have a note from Jackson. Okay, so Jackson's piece is called Jackson Doesn't Know the Measure. We have a tally on our board in the orchestra room of how many times Jackson goes, wait, what? Because he never knows what measure we're on, but we love him dearly. So Jackson says, hi everyone, my name is Jackson, and my piece is named Jackson Doesn't Know the Measure because of my definitely very good ability to listen in class for what measure we're on. This is a short duet for violin and cello. Jackson's in Austria skiing, and Jacob is in Hawaii. So, yeah, and we're here. beautiful Vermont. This is a blurb from Jacob for his piece, Tastes Like a Bagel Without the Bagel. Hello, my name is Jacob Kaufman Ilstrup, and I wrote the piece, Tastes Like a Bagel Without the Bagel. I started by just randomly putting notes down and writing a bunch of random phrases. Eventually, I started to string together all those phrases into what is now Tastes Like a Bagel Without the Bagel. I had no idea what to name this piece, so I asked my classmate, Indy Roberts, shout out, and she came up with the name, Tastes Like a Bagel Without the Bagel. I don't know what caused her to conjure this name, but I liked it, so it stuck. Enjoy.
And my piece is called Bubba's Swamp Stuff. I named it that because, I thought it kind of sounded swampy. And yeah, I don't know. So, enjoy.
Thank you. evening. My name is Marie Vosian. Originally, this piece was called A Stroll at Night, but this duet, Weeping Heavens, is for clarinet and cello. I originally named the piece A Stroll at Night, but the name didn't match the flow of the song. But when I came across the name Weeping Heavens, I believe that the name matched the piece. So here she is, and I hope you enjoy.
I'm Luke. I wrote a piece for cello and flute, and I forgot to title it.
my dearest Via, oh how I miss you, is named that because it's for like the memory of a friend that I used to have, but we drifted apart. And yeah, all right.
Hi everyone, my name is Ben Wetter. I wrote the song French Fries. It's a solo for French horn, and I called it that because French fries and the French horn are both two things that we call French, or are actually French. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. My name is Asa. I play cello. I'm a 10th grader, and I wrote a piece called CC's Duet. C for cello, C for clarinet. Hope you enjoy.
And my piece is called Sparkling Discontinuation. It's funny, it kind of, I've been told, sounds like the way my older brother Callum Robicek names his pieces, but that was not intended. Anyway, this piece, when I wrote it, in the past my pieces have been kind of a little weird. I don't know why, but this one I kind of tried to make a little less weird. So it's supposed to kind of be like simple and calming was my goal. So anyway, I really, thanks to these great musicians.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Henry, and sticking with the Crocs theme, my piece is called Crocs with Socks. Hope you enjoy.
My name is Grace, and my piece is called Dance of the Shadows for cello, violin, and bass. Thank you.
name is Zoe, and I wrote a piece of Ungulo for clarinet and flute. Thank you.
And I would like to introduce my piece that I wrote this year. If you were here last year, perchance, which I guess a lot of you weren't, but who knows. I must inform you that this is not another song along the lines of March of the Beans. No, I tried to give it an actual theme this time. I think it turned out well. Even if I did have the trouble coming up with a name, and it took me a while, but I found one that fits, and once you hear the piece, I think you'll understand what I was thinking. Without further ado, here's Echoes.
Thank you.
Chalk weather. I'll give you more than that because I've been doing this for a really long time. I can't even remember how long, and this is my last one. And this program has changed my life, to be honest. That man has changed my life. I was writing the piece coming off of the back of this huge project for the VSO, which took me a few months to write, and I was like creatively completely, like I had nothing. And so I decided to just try and draw inspiration from somewhere that I like would never think to. And what I ended up doing was taking a big band chart from the 40s that I'm playing with a big band, and taking some voicings of jazz chords and sort of building off of that, and I really like it. So, if you'll endure one more.
Shout out for Carter Oborowski for not being afraid to pickle apart. Thank you, Carter. Hey, well done, everybody. I'm so proud of you guys. This was such a great experience for me. I hope you enjoyed it too. Thank you so much, Eric, for teaching me a lot about composing and how to start these kids when they're so young doing something that is really, really beautiful. And I am so excited to keep doing it. Thank you so much, composers, and I will see you all next year. Oh, I'll see you guys. Check your calendars in the program. There's some future events coming up. Two things. First thing is that in March 17th, Jamie Maddox-White is premiering a piece with the Vermont Philharmonic, which all of us except Michael and Aaron play in, so we'll be there playing Jamie's piece, hooray. So come out and see that if you can. And Eric is also premiering a piece with, It's a piece that he's had premiered before on our April concert, which I can't remember, 28th? 27th and 28th. So if you're interested in hearing some new music by living composers that are in our community, please come out and check that out. Happy February break, everybody. Have an amazing, amazing break, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you.